growing up in the city was lots of fun. My friends and I often got into mischief. We were the mischief makers. I liked drawing too. And by age 10, I had created my candy gang comic characters. They represented the kids in the neighborhood. I've always enjoyed art and have brought the gang to life. I create posters, homemade animations, comic strips, ceramic characters, and small computer games, as well as t-shirts. I've had local write-ups and showings too. It's a great feeling to have gotten responses from much larger animation companies. I am always at the drawing table, coming up with new ideas to share. Yeah, I'm sitting here in the office. I just got through uploading my newest creation. Well, it's not new. Actually, I started doing animation, and it was in 2003 I actually completed my first animation. So, but now I'm going back and I'm making it a little better, and I'll also be adding on some new animation as well. So, the strip itself is centered around my childhood. I started out in Chicago, in the Robert Taylor's. So as you can see, Chicago line. And that's where I started at, in Chicago, before moving out to the suburbs. And so the strip is around my childhood. It's a lot of fun, you know. I'm still learning with the multimedia arts and stuff, but it's something fun. I've always enjoyed doing since a kid, so, and I hope you do too. Well, I'll be uploading to my YouTube page, CHET PICKENS, and you can find out my comments, and I do hope you enjoy them, so stand by. One of my favorite stories from a child was by this guy, Ezra Jack Keats, and so I remember him from when I was early grammar school, and I would read his books. A couple of my favorites were titled Goggles, and the other one was A Snowy Day. Those are my two favorites. So like they were hand paintings. I'm not quite sure, but they were very interesting, and I enjoyed them, and I always remember them. So one day I was gonna do a Black History report, and so I remember him. I remember his name, and I remember the books, and so I went to look him up. And to my surprise, he wasn't a black guy at all, and that was cool. You know, it was surprising to me, because all his characters in his books, pretty much they were black, you know, and it's kind of like they was in the city. And so when I looked them up and I found them, this is he right here. I just put them up on the net, and that's him. So, and I think that's pretty cool, because myself being an artist, I would like my work to, you know, when you look at my work, I want it to be for anybody or everybody, whoever enjoys it. So, anyway, I redid his
his story goggles, and I used my candy game characters and I animated it. So hopefully you'll like my version of Ezra Jack Keith's original story goggles. So I'm going to share it with you. Support my Chet the Jet logo. I created this logo. Besides comics, I'm a multi-master boxing champion, you know. And when I started doing the boxing as a kid, I always wanted to be like one, like a lot of the greats, you know, Muhammad Ali, you know, when I was coming up in the 70s, you know. And I would hear about, you know, your Joe Louis, and eventually later on, you know, your Ray Leonard's. And so I wound up getting into a division. There's the Masters division. And so I took it and I just ran with it. I would travel. I would just get on the Greyhound bus and just travel, man. I mean, this is a picture right here that of my accomplishments. I would just basically
like a fight. But that's what we used to do. Everybody go in the basement or out back, you know, and just fight, man. And so I was about 19 when I first got into the gym, to a real gym, and that's where the training actually started. And I still didn't fight for a long time. I actually just learned. It was an older guy. We used to call him Judo. He was like in the 70s at the time. And so he taught me a lot of good stuff. And later, it paid off. And so I've done very well in the boxing. So now I try to give back by helping other people too as well. I've been all over. Here goes some of the things I've collected, like the title belt shirts, a lot of title stuff. Got my own collection, Chet the Jet t-shirt. I got my original Chicago Golden Gloves, and all of the shorts and stuff that I've fought in. And one of my favorites, the Cuban athletic jacket, that's one of my favorites, and also the tank top that I fight in. I got my ring side that was given to me, and of course the Master Games, and the classics, the Arnold Classics, the Golden Gloves. So it's been a lot of fun. That's what I did. I put together a short animated film with the candy game, because everything I've been doing has basically been it's basically been hand in hand. It goes.
You and me, boy, I'm gonna bust you up.
animation. This is my studio. And when I first started doing animation, I started back in 2000. Well, I finished my first piece on my home computer about 2003. So now my goal was always to upgrade and just get out there and compete with the bigger companies. But I'm a one man. I'm by myself. So basically, it's just about me against the world, basically. Me and the candy gang. So this is the first piece I completed. Look at it. It was pretty much hand-drawn. I did it frame by frame. I lost the original program, well, the original files. And you can see that it wasn't, actually it wasn't all the way in color and stuff. So now I'm bringing all this stuff back to life. I'm bringing all this stuff back to life now. And basically, this is the newest piece that I just started. You know, with the newer technology, I was able to go back and sharpen it up. So that's my goal with the candy gang is to bring it out and make some of the best animation out there for the children, even adults, for all to enjoy. So be on the lookout.